The DJ Idea Sharing Podcast is brought to you by the American Disc Jockey Association. We help DJs build and grow their business.
Hi, this is Randy Bartlett, and you're listening to the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network.
It's me, Mike Fornino, and I'm your host for the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network Archive. Passion. What does that word mean to you? Do you live your life with passion? Do you bring passion to every performance? Today in the archive, I speak with a man who lives the word passion every day of his life. He is one of the most beloved figures in our industry. Anyone who has ever met the man unilaterally agrees he is a person who loves life. I'm speaking about none other than Sean Big Daddy McKee. I have the privilege and honor to know Sean as he operates directly in my market located here in Southern Connecticut. I can tell you, I know no finer human being on the planet, and my sentiments are shared by many. Today in the archive, we go back to the DJ Times show in Atlantic City and talk with the newly crowned DJ of the year from that show. Sean reflects on his performance, his passion, and of course, his two sons, who are the light of his life. On a very serious note today, I want to mention that Sean is a cancer survivor, and every Friday, I receive a text message from him reminding me to celebrate life and to live with no regrets. When you hear the lead intro into the program, introducing me into the podcast, that is the voice of my very dear friend, Gary Peters. Gary was blessed with one of the great voices I have ever heard out of an announcer. Gary passed away this year at a very young age. And Sean's message to me every Friday reminds me of how fragile and short life really is. It's time to get passionate and celebrate life with Big Daddy, today on the Archive.
The DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network, live from Atlantic City, sponsored by the American Disc Jockey Association. We help DJs build and grow their business. SureGlow, the best glow product online at www.sureglow.com. And Northern Light FX for all your sound and lighting needs. Call them at 888-660-6696 or online at www.northernlightfx.com. Live from the DJ Times Expo in Atlantic City, it's Mike Fornino on the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network.
Hello again from the show floor at DJ Times, DJ Expo 2007 in Atlantic City. I'm Mike Fornino with the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network. We are sponsored today by our wonderful, wonderful friends, the American Disc Jockey Association. We help DJs build and grow their business. And our good friend Dan at SureGlow, some of the best glow products you will ever find. You can find them online at sureglow.com. Speaking of friends, this gentleman is in my market, and I adore him. I just have so much respect for you, sir.
Thank you.
Sean Big Daddy McKee on the Podcast Network. How you doing?
Oh, fine, thanks. How you doing? How's everybody out there? Hope everybody's having a wonderful day.
Everybody who comes to this show, and even the one in Vegas, they've seen you do your thing. You know, when you were on stage right before Chubby Checker, you were out doing your thing. Mike Walter turned to me, and he was like in awe, and he just said, man, he just delivers that from the heart. You do. It all comes right from the heart.
You know what? As I tell everybody, and I tell you guys all the time, we are totally blessed to be able to do what we do. Right now, and I'll put it bluntly to everybody, the world sucks. When you go on the news, you read the paper, either somebody's getting killed or somebody's doing this or that or the other thing. For 4 or 5 hours, we get to make a difference in somebody's life and make them forget about what's going on in the quote-unquote real world. And if we can put a smile on one person's face a day, our job is the greatest job in the world, and I will do this until I can't do it anymore, until I can't speak. And making somebody smile on a daily basis. Who's got it better than us? Who's got it better than us? That's all I can say.
That seems to be like the prevailing attitude that I've been getting today by many of the people speaking. Who's got it better than us? And that's just something we have to try to focus on. When I see DJs all upset with what they do or complaining about a bride or a bar mitzvah mom or whatever, if we're crying out loud, who's got it better than us?
It's a natural thing to complain. That's what it's all about. You got to. It's not one of these things. It's not a perfect world. Yes, we have bar mitzvah and bat mitzvah moms that are going to drive us nuts. We have bridezillas, groomzillas every now and again. But you know what? In the end, they all believe, if they hire us, if they believe in us enough to hire us, we're going to do the right thing for them. And there's no doubt about that. And the one thing that drives me completely crazy is I see when we come to these DJ shows, and I have the pleasure of sharing whatever I do, and everybody else has a pleasure of sharing what they do, and people sit around and watch you and think that they know everything. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you, you don't. And if you think you know everything, you're in the wrong business, because I learn something new every day. I've been doing this for a long, long time.
Now, you run the entertainment division at James Daniel Entertainment in Stamford, Connecticut.
I'm the general manager and partner, head of the disc jockey section, and plus everything else that we do.
Are you involved with the bands as well?
Yes, I do book the bands. We have four bands. One is a Jimmy Buffett band that we do during the summer. And you know what? When I first got there 15 years ago, it was 70% band, 30% DJ. Turn that number around and add about 3 or 4% DJ, and it's about 73-27 right now, DJ, excuse me. And the thing is, when I first started back in 15 years ago, everybody thought that you had to have a band to have an elegant wedding. Well, I'm here to tell you, DJs know how to throw an elegant wedding. Thanks to all the new upgrades, the facades, and everything else, you can have an elegant wedding by having a DJ there. It just depends on who your DJ is.
Yeah. Now, we've been talking to a lot of people about the interactivity in their market. You're right in our market, and you're in one of the best markets in the country, which is the Fairfield County, Connecticut market.
Right.
You're catering to Westchester, New York, all of New York, in fact, New Jersey, all of Connecticut, New England. Great market to be in. What's your take on brides, specifically at weddings, saying, I don't want this, I don't want that, no line dances, no line dances? What are you seeing, John?
You're going to find, you look in magazines, whatever, The Knot, and whatever kind of magazine you look, you're going to find, because of websites like The Knot and any other web in the world, you're going to find older brides, number one. Number two, they have been together as a couple a long time. And everybody seems to think that they know, because they've been to a wedding, that they know what goes on at a wedding. And yes, I want to do everything in my power to make their day the most beautiful day that they've ever had in their life. All I want at the end of the day is you to come up to me and hug me and say, this was my dream come true. Well, the biggest problem that I'm seeing now, and yes, they don't want as much interaction, where 5 years ago, they wanted the party goods, they wanted the neons, they wanted everything else, and plus they wanted the Macarena, they want the electric side, they want goofy. Not goofy, but you know what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah.
Now, it's all about just playing the music and making sure people have a good time. You can still have interaction without doing the Macarena. Interaction doesn't mean going on the dance floor and acting like a jerk. I can do that behind the board. I can be a jerk behind the board just as good as I can on the dance floor. It's all about the music you play, the timing that you do it in, how you speak on the microphone, if you're not a circus act on the microphone, and everything else like that. You gotta let the party make itself. Help them out a little bit, start them out a little bit, give them a little nudge, and let the party run from there. That's what people want. They want, and the thing is, everybody wants a different wedding. There is no cookie cutter wedding, but the music you're going to hear is the same music at every wedding, whether they like it or not. If you haven't heard it on the radio, they won't dance to it. If they've heard it on the radio, no matter what it is, yeah, you can get away with no I Will Survive or Celebration. There's a lot of good music out there that nobody ever plays. And there's some new music that you can get away with, unlike some of the stuff that we're watching here. Commercial stuff that you can pull off without having to go completely crazy. And you know what? We live in a cynical world. And if you get that, again, I go back to how blessed we are. But
brides and grooms know what they want. They're older. And if you get young ones, you'll know if they're young when they want the Macarena and everything else like that. And the big thing is that you're getting nowadays is how much are you? The first question out of their mouth is how much are you? If you ask me that first, I'll say I'm not the guy for you. And that may sound cocky or whatever the case may be. If you're shopping for price alone, I'm not the guy for you.
And I know for a fact that the majority of the people that come to you, they're coming to you because they've heard, they've been referred, or they've seen you.
Correct.
And they want Big Daddy to do their event.
That's 95% of the people that I deal with have seen me or something, and still they either want a video or they want to come and see me at a wedding. I don't know about you, but it used to be where, yes, you could come to a place and go see a person at a wedding. I don't allow people to do that because I wouldn't want somebody coming to my wedding and crashing my wedding and watching my DJ. If you can't judge by 10 people referring me and you've seen me before, why do you need to go see me again? I don't understand that, but that's the world we live in.
Right. You have some pretty impressive client people that patronize your service.
Yeah, we're lucky. We're lucky. I've worked for Brian Gumbel, Kathy Lee Gifford, WWE people. There's a bunch of other people. And opening for Chubby Checker was kind of cool at Mobile Beat. It doesn't matter where I do it. I honestly have no idea why, but I get treated like a rock star by people that I have never met before in my life. And I'm so thankful to be able to share with people what I do. I can't give you any more than I right here. I give you my heart, and that's all I'm going to give you.
That's because what goes around comes around, and you give so much, and people are just giving back to you in appreciation for everything you give to them.
Well, the thing is, one of the things that I have a problem with, and we discussed that this afternoon, is I never say no. I will never say no to anybody, no matter what they want, if they need me. And we talk all the time, and we're not in direct competition, but we're, you know, in the same area, in the same, pretty much the same market. I talk to other people that are in my market all the time. There is so much work out there for everybody. Why be territorial? I'm blessed. I work from here to Orlando, to Vegas, California, Chicago, Philadelphia. Who's got it better than me? So the cream always rises to the top, as they say. Service is a big thing. And now with laptops and all the stuff that we're seeing here, anybody and their mother can become a DJ right now. But they can't become an entertainer.
That's right.
You can't rehearse. You can't give somebody heart. You got to have it. And that's what I think a lot of these people that are walking around here don't understand.
Well, you know, the glam and the glitz, it's on the show floor here. We are coming to you live from the DJ Times Expo 2007, by the way. You couldn't tell by all the noise in the background.
Hey, there's no more. This is the quiet room, by the way, folks. Just to let you know, we're in the quiet room. Have a nice day.
I know you're really proud. You're a great father. You love your kids.
That's without a doubt.
You always tell people when, like, if you call Big Daddy's answering machine, you get the. He always says, "Hug your kids." How is it? I seen you walking around with your son. How is it to be Big Daddy at the convention, having your son with you?
How is it being Big Daddy, having my son anywhere with me? I have two boys. One's 23. He's a rocker, and I used to be a rocker, so. Trying to tell him not to do that, oh boy, how stupid am I? But having my son with me like I was last night, and I want everybody to know that that is my son. I am the proudest father in the world because of the man that he's becoming, the man that he wants to be. And the thing I respect about him the most is he doesn't want to be Little Daddy. He wants to be DJ Wider. He wants to be Casey. And trying to explain that to people and tell them that it's okay with me that he become his own person. That's what it's all about. And I am, last night, I might have gotten a little over the top with introducing my son because I want everybody to know who my son is. I am so proud of him, and everything that he does, he's done on his own. I mean, I've been there. My kids are 21 and 23 years old. I talk to my kids 4 and 5 times a day. People go, what? Yeah, I talk to my kids all the time. I talk to them before they go to bed. I said, guys, you got to call me, tell me you love me before you go to bed, or I'll embarrass you in front of your friends. And they do. But their friends think I'm hip because I wear earrings and I'm Big Daddy or whatever, and they want to know how to get a hug from me. I said, all you got to do is walk up to me.
Now, is he going on events with you, working with you, two pieces?
He is one of my most requested younger DJs. He's got a partner that you guys will meet tomorrow, another one of my guys. And he's a great mixer, and he's very, the one thing I did teach him was get to events early, and he drove me crazy, why? And when what happened was his main system went down, he was there early enough to be able to set up his second system in time to start. He goes, now I know why, and he'll never be late again. And you know what? I'm proud of him for that fact, too. And yes, being my son is probably the biggest pain in the neck in the world, because everywhere I go, somebody knows me. I'm blessed that way. I'm just very, very lucky that way. But being my son has got to be tough, because all he keeps hearing is, your dad is this, your dad is this, your dad is this. And I try to tell them, my son is this. That's who he is. He's a great kid. He wants to be the kid that hated high school wants to be a teacher now. God bless him.
Wow. That's fabulous. Now, you're going to be competing tomorrow night, because right now, as we're recording this, this is Tuesday, and tomorrow night is the DJ of the Year competition. I don't have to wish you luck, because you've got talent and you don't need luck, but I still want to just give you my best, because I don't care if you put in all the magazines and all the bridal show books that I'm in, that you're DJ of the Year. If anyone deserved being DJ of the Year, it's you, Sean. You've done so much, and you give so much, and I wish you all the best tomorrow night.
You know, Michael, thank you. Stephen, thank you. Everybody, I thank you very much. And for those of you listening, keep listening to these guys and get on the idea sharing boards and everything else like that. It's all about giving back. If you don't give back, you ain't going to get anything back. And you know what? It doesn't matter if I win. I already won already, being able to share with what I did last night or what I do tomorrow night. And Big Daddy loves you. That's all I can tell you.
He does. He does. He really does. I'm going to have one more question for you, and that is, you are so accomplished in what you do. You've done so much, and yet you still come to these shows. For anyone listening that feels that they're above coming to an event, or they say, I've got a party to do, I don't know, I can't really go. Why is it beneficial to go to these events year after year, Sean?
You know what? Number one, it's to see all of the friends that you don't get to see. But most important is you never stop learning. If you stop learning, there's something wrong. It doesn't matter if you pick up one little nugget on your first night here. You walk around, you see, you get to talk to people that are from out of your area, learn about other people's areas, because there might be something you can do that you don't do now that you say, it may work, it may not work. Give it a shot. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. But you can never, ever stop learning. And don't ever think you can. Don't ever think you can stop learning, because you can't. I'm still learning. I'll never stop learning. Heaven forbid.
Heaven forbid. Great advice from a great guy. Sean, thank you, my friend.
Absolutely my pleasure, gentlemen. And for those of you listening, DJIdearSharing.com. And the other thing, to get onto the forums, get onto the forums. Let people know that you're there. Thanks, guys.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
And I'm so proud to name the 2007 DJ of the Year. You know he loves it. Big Daddy.
Sean, DJ of the Year, 2007. Congratulations, my friend.
Thank you very much, Ben. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. It was, if you don't go to a DJ conference, if you don't come to DJ Times and see things like the DJ of the Year competition, you're missing out on so much. The whole event last night was electric. It was amazing. All the competitors were fantastic. Wonderful, wonderful stuff that they shared. And Sean, you just got up there and you just blew your heart out on the stage, man. It was awesome.
If they're looking for my heart, they'll find it on the dance floor, because I got nothing left.
You aren't kidding. You gave it all. One of the best moments was at the very end, and you found out you were DJ of the Year. And everyone came, they rushed you right there with your son, Casey, you brought out with you. And in your speech, I mean, it brought a tear to my eye. It was wonderful. I want to introduce Casey, we're not going to call you Little Daddy.
No, it's just Casey.
Yeah, that's right. Casey, welcome to the program. You must be so proud of Dad.
I am very proud, and as everybody has said, it is long overdue since he's, you know, been the champion this year. So finally, He got it.
Well, I told your dad he was a champion way before, but this just confirms it now.
He needs it on paper for some reason.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
I think he just wanted the plaque to adorn his wall.
Exactly. Yeah. It'll be on his card by next month. So
next month, right next week. What are you kidding me? I'm not stupid.
Casey, what are your plans now? I know that you've been going out with dad and doing some stuff. What's next for you? Where are you going with this?
I have been a DJ for about 5 years now. I am also in school to become an English teacher.
Nice.
So for the next year, I'm going to be working as hard as I can and being in school. And then in the next year, I'm going to be going to pursue my career of being an English teacher and moving to South Carolina, actually, to go to college at a five-year program to get my master's degree. So
fabulous. Excellent. Now I know why he's so proud of you.
Exactly.
And I'm going to be the most miserable son of a gun you've ever met when he leaves me.
Yes, but I know you'll go down there, and I know you'll be calling him every day, Sean.
Oh, and I know that, too. We all know. Even people that don't know him know that. So
he said that he talks with his kids at least 4 times daily.
And we live in the same state, so it's a little weird. And that's just in the morning, by the way.
Yeah, what's your phone bill going to be like, Sean?
Thank God I have 2,000 minutes a week. That's all I know.
Luckily, I have Verizon, and he does, too, so it's a little free.
Well, we wanted to bring you guys on and just congratulate you and just let everyone know that Big Daddy is now a champion. You always were a champion, but it's official. 2007 DJ Times DJ of the Year, Sean Big Daddy McKee. God bless, man.
Thank you guys very much. Love you all.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Vince.
And you are listening to the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network live from DJ Times, Atlantic City, 2007.
Listen to the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network anywhere your iPod or MP3 player device goes. You can also listen on your computer by going to our website, www.djideasharing.com. Just select Podcast Network. Music provided by the PodSafe Music Network. Check it out at music.podshow.com. This has been a production of the DJ Idea Sharing Podcast Network.